Hi everyone, it's Caitlin Cahill, the geek you need. Today I'm going to show you how to create a standard college-ruled notebook page in Canva. So to begin with, after you log into Canva, you're going to click the custom size button in the upper right. Now you want to add your size in either inches, millimeters, or centimeters. I'm going to be creating a standard US letter size notebook, so I'm going to do inches. Now, because you need the lines to extend all the way to the edge of the page, you need to add your dimensions with your bleed included. KDP requires a 0.125 inch bleed or 3.2 millimeters on your outside edges, so three of your edges. So for a college ruled page, I'm going to do 8.625 wide by 11.25 inches tall. This will give me bleed on the top, the outside edge, and the bottom edge. So now that I have my document up, you want to have your ruler showing. So if you don't see your rulers here, go to File and click on Show Rulers. The first thing we're going to do is add guidelines for the top and the bottom of the lines because we want a bit of the margin at the top and we want space at the bottom for one of the lines. So from the top, you're going to click on your ruler and you're going to drag that down until you get to about 1.125 from the top. That'll give you a 1-inch margin after that 0.125 bleed is cut off. Now it doesn't have to be exact. You can see on the left-hand side, it tells me how far down I am. So I'm going to click until that number says about 1.125. Right now it's 1.123, that's close enough. And then I'm going to do that again for the bottom, and I'm going to drag this down to about 10.6. So again, 10.6 gives me my 11-inch page minus the 0.125 bleed cutoff minus the 0.375 margin requirement. So now that I have my guidelines, these are just to help me lay out my lines. These will not actually print on the document. So I need to add all of my lines in between these two guidelines. So on the Elements tab, I'm going to select the line. If you don't see it, go up to the search. You can either click the suggested lines or type in line. And then you just want the plain one without any beginning or ends. Or you could do dashed or other styles if you want. We're going to start with just a plain line. Now the default is too dark and too thick for what I want. So first thing I'm going to do is up here, I'm going to change the color to a lighter gray. And then I'm also going to change that line weight all the way to 1 pixel. Once I have my lines the weight and color that I want to click on these white circles on the edges and drag them all the way to the edge of the page because I want my line to go all the way to the edge. So once I have my first line, I'm going to move it up to the upper left, and you'll see why I kind of move it off the page in a second. So I need a total of 35 lines for this document. So I have one. So I'm going to duplicate this line 34 times. So on a Mac, the keyboard shortcut is Command and D, so you want to click those at the same time. On a PC, it's Control and D. So do that 34 times for a total of 35 lines. So once you have your 35 lines, take that top line and move it so that it aligns with that top ruler. Now it doesn't have to be perfectly centered yet because we'll change that in a minute. It just has to be vertically aligned with that guideline. Now do the same with your bottom line and align it with the bottom ruler. You can tell it's aligning with that ruler because the ruler highlights in that light violet color. So if I were to turn off my guidelines, you can see My lines are lined up at the top and the bottom there. Now what you want to do is select all of your lines. So because we only have lines, we could do Command A or Control A and that will select them all. If you have other elements on the page, you can click and drag around all the elements to select them all. So once your lines are selected and you have those lines at the top and the bottom, from the top menu, go to Position, click Center so that they all line up horizontally. And then again, under the Position menu, you're going to click Tidy Up. What Tidy Up does is it spaces all of your elements evenly, but between the top and the bottom element. So that's why we lined up those first. If you space them evenly vertically, it'll vertically space them across the entire document. But we want that extra space at the top and bottom, so we're going to do Tidy Up. And then to keep all my lines together, I'm going to click Group to keep them in one group. And then now I can move them over to the center of the page. So again, if I turn off those guides, which won't print anyway, you can see I have my college ruled lines. So now to finish this, let's add a vertical rule on the left-hand side for our margin. So I'm going to turn my guides back on. And this time I'm going to click and drag from the vertical ruler on the left, and I'm going to go over to about an inch and a quarter. Again, it doesn't have to be exact. Now again, the guideline doesn't print. That's just to help me add a line, so I do still need to go to my elements, click that plain line element again. Now it automatically added it at the same color as before, but I need to change my weight. And then this icon here with the two arrows is what will rotate it. So I'm going to click on that and I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees or negative 90, either one works. Once it's vertical, click and drag it over to that guideline. Again, you can tell it's on the guideline because that vertical line is a magenta color with the measurement highlighted. Now I can see I must have let go too quickly because it's a little bit off. So I'm going to rotate that again. There we go. And then using those white circles, I'm going to click and extend the edge of the page so it's as tall as the page. If I turn off those guidelines again, you can see I now have a nice vertical margin on the left. I usually do most of my KDP interiors in black and white because it's much cheaper and most people don't mind. But if maybe you want to do a printable or you're doing a colored notebook, you could certainly make these the traditional red and blue lines. So with my vertical one selected, I can go ahead and change that color up here to red. Select all of your horizontal lines. Now you'll notice it also selected this vertical line, so I'll want to hold down Shift and click on that vertical line to unselect it. So now just my horizontal lines are selected, and I can change those to blue. So now we have your standard college ruled 8.5 by 11 page, but obviously you would need a few more if you're going to actually make a notebook for KDP. So there's a couple ways you can do it. If you want to do it entirely within Canva, you can click this duplicate icon up here, and you would want to do that for as many pages as you need. Now, depending on how large of a notebook you go, Canva does limit the number of pages that you can output to 100. So if you're going to do more than that, you're going to have to use a program to combine your documents. I often will save a template page as one or maybe 10 pages, and then I use Adobe Acrobat to put them together. And I'll link a video in the description that shows how to duplicate pages in Adobe Acrobat. So once you had all the pages you needed, so let's just add a couple here just for the sake of illustration. So once you have all your pages, go up to the download menu. And instead of PNG, you want the PDF print quality. And you want to leave all the other settings the same. So do not click crop marks and bleed. So you already added the bleed when you created your document size. If you were to click this, it would also add printer crop marks, which is KDP does not want, and it'll create an error when you upload. So leave that unchecked. You definitely want to download all of your pages and then click download to save your PDF. And you're all set to upload your interior to KDP. I hope this was helpful. Let me know if there's any other interiors you want to see me make in Canva, Word, Photoshop, or any other program.